What is going on, everyone? Lauren Sisler here with AL.com. Jim Dunaway with the Jocks Roundtable, and it is the holiday season. It is the time of giving, and it is the time for bowl football games.
That's right, a little head-to-head. We'll talk Music City Bowl. Auburn, a 3.5-point favorite, according to Danny Sheridan. You've got the cool hat. I don't have one. But when it comes to a cool trip here, Nashville's a great trip for the Auburn fans who will go up. I love this city. I don't like this matchup. Dangerous Purdue team for the Auburn Tigers.
All right, let's go three and out, and we'll start with first down, Jim. Key playmaker for Auburn in this matchup.
Key playmaker for Auburn is Deshaun Davis and that linebacking core. Rondale Moore for Purdue is one of the most unbelievable playmakers that you will get in college football. And I promise you, he will need to be on his game so that you can control that little piece of real estate from the line of scrimmage to about 5 to 10 yards deep. That's where Purdue could kill this Auburn team.
So key for Auburn is going to be offensive line play. I think these are guys that can open up the seams, allow Auburn to run the football, because I think it's going to be important to have balance in this football game. I think control the tempo, control the line of scrimmage, and I think that gives Auburn an advantage in this one.
So second down is going to be the biggest threat for Auburn. I think I maybe mentioned one that's going to be pretty big and more. Do you have another one?
I don't have another one. I was going to go Rondale Moore. That's your guy. He's a big one. He's a huge threat. He leads the FBS right now in receptions. He is the most explosive freshman in the entire country right now in terms of a receiver picking up big yards. On the flip side of that, though, Auburn is only allowing 7.3 yards per play. So I think that's going to be important for this Auburn defense to really step up and try to eliminate some of that explosiveness that you might see from Moore.
The biggest threat for Auburn is the fact that Jeff Brohm did not take the Louisville job. He's staying here at Purdue. This game for him means he's building for next year and keeping his Purdue program moving forward. Jeff Brohm is one of the better play callers in all of college football. Gus Malzahn used to be one of those, and now Gus is back calling plays in this game. It'll be interesting to see if Brohm or Malzahn is a better play caller on this 160-minute field.
Yeah, motivation certainly plays a key in that. And on the topic of Gus Malzahn, how important, in your opinion, is this win for Auburn and for Gus Malzahn?
I think it's a zero outcome either way. I don't think it really erases any of the woes of the season if you win it. And it doesn't make it any worse if you lose it. 7-5, 7-6, 8-5, it is what it is. And part of that is that Jarrett Stidham's your quarterback when we're taping this. He's going to be the quarterback in this, and he's not back next year, right? So it's going to be a different team next year. To me, it doesn't matter if they win it or lose it. It truly is an exhibition game for Auburn.
I couldn't agree with you more. I do think that obviously in a game like this, it always helps to kind of have that carry over to the next season, but we're pretty much wiping the slate clean, and I think everybody has had that disappointment this season and would like to just kind of move on. But a win is a win, so obviously a win is always a good thing. So now it's time to dip down under the Christmas tree and see what we would like to be giving Auburn head coach Gus Malzahn for Christmas. If you could give him anything at all, what would it be?
For Gus Malzahn this year, I would give him a Xerox machine so that he can make, it's like that Michael Keaton movie, what was it, Multiplicity, where you get more Michael Keatons, you get more Gus Malzahn. You don't want a whole staff of Gus Malzahn's. Kevin Steele's side of the football is pretty good, but make a whole offensive side of Gus Malzahn's so he can be the head coach, he can be the offensive coordinator, he can be the quarterback coach. However many Gus's you need to fill out a coaching staff, what a great gift it will be. And that's not a shot at Gus. I think Gus Malzahn should be calling plays at Auburn. He should be, because that's what he's good at. And if he's gonna get fired or he's gonna have success, I would wanna do that being what I'm good at, and that would be calling plays. And also, the debate on whether Chip was calling plays or Gus is calling plays, if I Xerox Gus Malzahn, there's no debate. We know he's calling plays, everyone's gonna pull in the same direction, and that's what Auburn needs most right now, is everybody pulling in the same direction.
I wanna know how many comments are gonna be below this video reminding everyone that you look like Michael Keaton.
Yeah.
On that topic.
Michael's old now, and so am I.
Stop it, Jimmy. Okay, I'm gonna go with the gift to the Auburn football team. I wanna give them a can, a big old can of whoop butt.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that these guys look.
So they can open it on Purdue?
Open it up on Purdue. Because okay. I think at the end of the day, yes, as you said, this doesn't change really the landscape of this Auburn football team going into next season. But think about it. These guys go out and fight every day. They play hard. You can't take any of that away, especially for the senior class. And I think for these guys to go out on top, you know, it's important to these guys. So I just want to give them that opportunity to go out there, kick some butt, take names, and We'll see it in 2019.
Yep. Let's make some predictions. And again, the point spread 3.5, according to Danny Sheridan. And for me, I will take Auburn winning this game 27-23. Entertaining bowl game. It's an outdoor game. Cold weather, you know, is a possibility always this time of year. But I think 27-23, 3.5 is the spread. I think you're very close to that with a 4-point win for Auburn.
I'm going to go 34-24. So I got Auburn scoring a little bit more on that one. But again, I think there are a little, you know, some factors in there. Obviously, Coach Brohm coming back, that's a big factor, motivational factor for this Purdue team. They've had some big wins, the big one being Ohio State. So they've kind of got that under their belt. But I do like this Auburn football team in this one. You know, I think Jarrett Stidham can still make some plays. And if they can run the football and attack on the ground, I think it helps them in this one for sure. And that's my prediction. So we'll see you. Bye-bye now.
And that's our season.
Sad day.
Had to have it.
I love you, Jim.
I love you, Lauren. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.